Hi there, class of 2024 parents and students, if you're watching. First thing I want to do is point out that we had a meeting this past Sunday. If you look below, you'll have a link to listen or see that meeting on video. I wish you would. It raised some very, very important information to your attention, like how to read your financial aid award, how to start enrollment. These are very important topics for you right now. And I wish you'd listen to that video, would you please? And then, of course, subscribe so you're not surprised in the future by videos that we drop. This video is going to be kind of like me reminding you, as I see people making their decisions and I look at the economy today, I think I need to, you know, remark on this. And that is that the interest rates are going to go up again. I expect the parent loan interest rate will be 9 or 10% by the time your student reaches college. It might be 8, but it's already 8 now. So I think 9 or 10 is where it's headed because inflation is still a factor right now. It was almost 4% this past month, and it already has been food and all that stuff has gone up 20-some percent already. And that means the Fed is going to be raising the interest rates, or at least keeping them where they are. And that means a very expensive parent loan for you parents. The student percentages aren't much, but for interest, but they're there and won't go up. But the majority of your loans are going to be your parent loan the way I'm seeing these decisions turn out. Now, again, I must caution you, you know, if your income is low, I'd say under $100,000. And you're looking at private schools, I've seen an extreme increase in costs. Some schools have gone up 15, 20% in 1 year. And that's because of food and housing costs have gone up at these campuses. And I just wonder what you're going to do. I mean, we just looked the other day. Look at that meeting I told you about in that link below. You'll find out USC is $95,000. $95,000. You'll find out LMU is $85,000, maybe $86,000, I think. And we're talking about just direct costs, tuition, room, and board. The tuition of USC is approaching, it's, I think, over $70,000 now per year, just the tuition. If they live on campus, that's another $20,000. Now, I just use USC as an example, but I'm seeing $80,000 and $90,000 private schools is very common. Now, sure, black schools are lower, but Howard's 50,000. It went up quite a bit in 1 year. They're not even saying that right now publicly. It's just last year's cost. And that's why they do that, parents. So you really need to be sure, parents, before you go into debt. Even if a school like that gives you 20, you're still 35,000, 40,000, 50,000 a year in debt. And you're going to take out a parent loan. I almost wish they didn't have them, but they have parent loans. The credit check on them is somewhat rigorous, but not terribly. You could be looking at an indebtedness of a fifth of a million, a fourth of a million, a third of $1 million by the time your student leaves college. And a lot of you all think that it'll just be forgiven. But parent loans are not subject to forgiveness anywhere, even though I know the president is kind of forgiven loans now that have been 10 years old, or I didn't say it right, that where the no payments have been made, which is not fair. We'll do a separate video on that. And they're over 10 years old. They're trying to forgive them now. I'm sure it'll be challenged at some point in the courts. But don't rely on forgiveness, parents. That's going to be money you owe. And look at the economy right now. If you have a $200,000 loan, you're going to pay back $260,000. Because of the interest rates. And I don't see the interest rates going anywhere until well after 24. They may drop in 26 if the presidency changes. But right now, if at the current spending levels of our government, I saw last budget suggest it was $8 trillion. That's what's causing inflation. So you got to really look at this, parents, and ask if this is in the best interest of your child. And you. Because if you're in debt, it's going to affect them. I know you want to send them to the school they want. I know you do, or the school of their choice. And I know you really want them to have a nice school. It's a nice thing to think about and tell your friends about, but I would not be a man of God if I didn't say to you, be aware of the cost. There's nothing wrong with going to a CSU or UC to cut your costs tremendously, especially CSU. Now, if you do two-year college for a couple of years, you could reduce your cost 50 to 60%. There's nothing wrong with two-year college. Stop calling it community college, by the way. It lowers it. It's two-year college. If they were to fail courses in a two-year college, that's the same effect of failing up there in the first 2 years of college. Now, the first 2 years of college are just going to be general ed classes, unless it's engineering or something. You can get those same classes at two-year college for way less. Really think about this, parents, please, before you make that decision to spend all that money. Not spend it, but go into debt. Now, if you've saved up that money, I mean, all of it, some of you may have, I come across about once or twice every season, somebody who saved up over $100,000. But even then, if a school is $250,000, $300,000, it's not going to help you. Listen, that feeling you parents that you get when you pick a school for your child and realize how much, by the way, I had a video last time, people are doing it before they know the cost. Then you find out the cost and you start thinking about the other schools. That's pretty much proof that you went too fast. It's too fast. And finally, I should address people who students have great grades and they could go to a school almost for free and they're aware of it. But they pick another school because of relatives or things they've heard or a feeling they get about the prestige of the school. And I wish and hope that that would not happen. I would hope that you would pick, if it's a great school and it's free, pick that school. You know, and time's running out. It's now April 9th or 10th. Some of you will see it on the 10th. You got to be visiting schools now. You're not going to visit every school. Hopefully you'll visit the ones that are the best buy. Now, schools that are not giving you the financial aid awards, they're dragging their heels. I don't think they're candidates. You might wait, but then you won't have time to visit it. And I know you're not going to go to send your child to a school they don't visit. That's why you should start pressuring them about that May 1st date, by the way. I don't think they can sustain that. They haven't told you the financial aid award yet. Anyway, if you want to get information on how to read the financial aid award, look below and click on that link. If you want to subscribe to this channel to get more videos like this, please do. I'll include my email address too. It's probably been on the screen below too, in the subtitles, but look in the, again, description block below. We'll have everything you need. You want to set up a meeting with me to talk about it, no matter where you're living. I'll be glad to talk to you. If you want me to kind of like adjudicate between different people in the family, I can do that because everybody needs to be in agreement in the house on a major expenditure like college and going into debt, which can ruin your retirement, parents. Thank you very much. Bye-bye now.